Hello guys, welcome to Learning with Prep Class. I am your tutor, Adindu. In this video, I'll be solving questions 16 to 19, which has to do with the section E of the Ugo-Sugo Quantitative Paper B Test 4 questions. After this video, you would have gained understanding on how to carefully select the correct answer when solving questions in quantitative. It's usually fun having you guys around, and I know this video will be a worthwhile session. Do not forget to like and subscribe on our YouTube channel. You can go the extra mile of leaving the comments so we can communicate for effective learning. Without further ado, let's zoom in. So we have section E, and we would need to build an understanding from these samples, because that understanding will help us in solving questions 16 to 19. Now, this is looking like 4 plus 3, but this is not a positive sign because it has a ring around it. So what this simply means is 4 plus 3 is 7. Then because we are adding 4 just to one number, it will be plus 1, that will give us 8. So what do I mean by that? So if I had on this side maybe a bracket 3 plus 2, it's going to be 3 plus 2 will give us 5. Then it will be 4 plus 5, which is 9, then plus 2, because there are two numbers on this other side. But since we just have only one number on this side, it will be 4 plus the number, which is 7, then plus 1, which will give us 8. Alright, so for this, it's the same approach. 7 plus 6 is 13, plus 1 will give us 14. Okay, for this, it will be 3.5 plus 8, and that will give us 11. Then 11 plus 1 will give us 12.5. So with this knowledge, we are going to be using it in solving questions 16 to 19. Let's try them out. Question 16. We've been asked to get this missing number. So we'll be implementing the knowledge from the sample. Let's see how we did it. So it will be 9. It's 9 plus and the ring sign 3. That will be equals to 12. 9 plus 3 is 12. Plus 1. That will give us equal to 13. So it is 12, which is 9 plus 3, 12 plus 1 equal to 13. So our correct answer would be 13. Let's check it out. Question 16, option D, 13 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 17, we've been asked to find this number here. So we'll definitely be implementing the knowledge from the sample. Let's try it out. So this number here plus 20 plus 1 will give us 30. But since we don't have this part here, it's going to be 30 minus 20, we'll get the answer, then minus 1 will give us the number. And that's 30 minus 20 is equal to 10. 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. So our correct answer that will be here is 9. And to prove this to be true, we are going to say 9 plus 20 will give us 29. 29 plus 1 will give us 30, which is this. So 9 is our correct answer here. Let's check it out. Question 17, option B, 9 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 18, we've been asked to resolve this. So let's see how to get it done. So it ought to be half plus this number plus 1 will give us 7.5. So since we don't have this, we're going to start by saying 7.5 minus half. The answer we'll get, then we'll say minus 1, then we'll get our answer. So 7.5 minus half, that will be 2 times 7 is 14 plus 1 is 15. So that will be 15.5 minus half. Since they have common denominators, that will be their LCM. That will be their lowest common multiple. It's because they have common denominators. So it will be 2. So we will just minus the numerators by saying 15 minus 1. So 15 minus 1 will give us 14. So it will be 14 over 2. So 14 over 2. 2 here, 1. 14 divided by 2 will give us equal to 7. So 7 minus 1 will give us equal to 6. Our answer that ought to be here should be 6. Now, to try it out, we're going to say half plus 6 will give us 6.5. 6.5 plus 1 will give us 7.5. So our correct answer for question 18 is 6. Let's check it out. Question 18, option B, 6 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 19. Now, we've been asked to find this. But remember, there are two numbers here. So after adding this together first, then adding it to this, the answer we get, usually we add 1 to it. But for this case, we are going to add 2 to it because there are two numbers here. Let's check it out. So it is 2.5, this 2.5 plus 10. Using board mass, we ought to do what's in the brackets first. So 2.5 plus 10. So 2.5 is 2 times 2 plus 1. That's 5 over 2 plus 10. We find the LCM of 2 and 1, that's 2. 2 here, 1. 2 here, 1. 1 times 5 is 5 plus 1. 2 divided by 1 is 2. 2 times 10 is 20. So we add the numerators. 5 plus 20 will give us 25 over 2. And 25 over 2, 2 here, 1. 2 in 25 will give us 12, remainder 1. So it will be 12 whole number, 1 over 2. That's what we got by adding this. Then we now add it to this half. So 12.5 plus half will give us 13. Because half plus half is 1. Then 12 plus 1 is 13. Then 13 plus 2, because there are two numbers here, we'll add 2 to it. 13 plus 2 will give us 15. So our correct answer here would be 15. Alright, let's check it out. Question 19, option E, 15, is our correct answer. Alright, this is how far we can go in this video. I hope we had fun. Our answers came out quite easy when we implemented the knowledge we got from the samples. I'm using this timeout to ask us to join our WhatsApp group using this link below so we can get updates on more videos to come, we can ask questions, and we can also comment on the previous videos we've seen. It was fun having you guys around. Till I come your way again. Bye!